I can't remember.
Yeah, I think about 90% of our patients are paying out of pocket, because we're kind of like the end of the line.
So Rolando's coming back, talking about IPL and where it stands these days.
And those are my disclosures, and we've already covered MGD. So in 2001, I was starting to do IPL, intense pulse light, for patients who had rosacea. And that was the indication back then. And these patients, after they had IPL, their telangiectasias would close and their rosacea was better. And some of those patients were saying that not only did I improve their rosacea, but they said their dry eye was better. So that started a whole trip for me on seeing if IPL could be used for dry eye. So here's one of our optometrists getting IPL. He has dry eye. And we all have patients like this with inspissated glands, thickening of the lid margin, telangiectasias, scurf, Demodex, and conj injection. So what is IPL? It's not a laser. It's a xenon flash lamp, so it's giving you light between 500 nanometers and about 1,000 nanometers. You're putting a special filter so that you only get a certain wavelength of light. So if you put a 600 filter, that'll block all the wavelengths of light before 600 and give you the wavelengths of light after 600. And then you can take that energy and you can pulse it. The importance of pulsing is that the thinnest skin of the face and of the whole body is right there at the lid margin. And when you're giving IPL, you want to hit that lid margin to get that wavelength of light to the meibomian gland. So if you were to give them all the energy all at once, you could cause scarring with these wavelengths of light on the lid margin. By pulsing the energy waves, you can give more energy and actually stimulate the meibomian glands more. So it was said in the previous talk, certain wavelengths of light will be recognized by oxyhemolume. This is about 590 nanometers to about 640. It's recognized by oxyhemoglobin, and that actually will coagulate and close off this telangiectasia. So one of the mechanisms of action for intense pulse light is closing off these telangiectasias. The other thing that we found is when this happens, you actually get a heating effect in the dermis. So if you think about what you're trying to do with a warm compress, you're trying to get heat from the outside into the dermis where the meibomian gland is so that you can actually melt those secretions and dilate the gland. When another mechanism of action that we found with intense pulse light, which is being used in hospitals and surgery centers now, is that actually these wavelengths of light will actually kill microorganisms. So they'll kill bacteria, they'll kill Demodex, they'll kill all these things. So one of the other mechanisms of why this works for anterior blepharitis is that these wavelengths of light will actually kill bacteria and kill those Demodex. So now we have these xenon intense pulse light robots that are put into a room. They go throughout a room, flashing this light, killing these microorganisms. So another mechanism of action for IPL, for dry eye, is killing off the microorganisms. The main reason why I realized why intense pulse light works for meibomian gland dysfunction is this process called photomodulation. So essentially, photomodulation is using wavelengths of light to actually stimulate the mitochondria and cells so the mitochondria and the cells work better. So this is being taken advantage of by retina surgeons and retina doctors, because they're using actually wavelengths of light to stimulate retina pigment epithelial cells in age-related macular degeneration patients to help age-related macular degeneration. And then this heating effect, which we're all trying to do when you're talking about a LIPA flow or a warm compress or these other types of technologies that are coming out. What we're seeing with IPL is we're generating so much heat, you know, close to anywhere from 43 degrees Celsius anywhere to 53. What it does is it actually melts these toothpaste-like secretions so that you can actually do expression, and it'll dilate the gland. So when we were talking earlier, when Dr. Tyler was talking earlier about squeezing on these glands, not getting anything out, what I've noticed is we really don't have to do probing on these glands. Once we do an IPL treatment, it opens up the glands and dilates the glands so much that you can easily express these glands and get this toothpaste-like secretion out. And as these patients go through these IPL treatments, what starts to happen is their secretions turn from this thick toothpaste-like secretion to more of a butter-like secretion. And then eventually, in a four-treatment protocol, you can go from toothpaste all the way to a normal-like secretion like olive oil. But what are we seeing on the lid margin on these patients? So this is a 35-year-old who was coming to us because she was having problems wearing her contact lenses, and that was her main complaint. But as you can see here, she had meibomian gland dysfunction. You push on these glands, nothing would come out. She has thickening of the lid margin. She has loss of eyelashes. She's got some signs of Demodex, some injection. And then this was just after two treatments. You see the eyelashes coming back. You're closing off those telangiectasias. You press on the gland now, and you're getting olive oil like secretion. So there's a mechanism of action that's making these lid margins better. So what are the mechanisms of action? People like to say IPL, oh, it's just heat, or it's just closing off telangiectasias, but there's so much more going on with intense pulse light and why it works for MGD and dry eye. So one is we know, and it's already been proven, that intense pulse light will kill microorganisms. So if you have an overgrowth of bacteria and Demodex, if you apply IPL to these patients, that you'll take care of that. Then heat and expression does work. So the reason why LipoFlow patients feel a little bit better is that you are getting some heat and expression of those glands. Another mechanism of action, closing off those telangiectasias. So we know that those telangiectasias secrete inflammatory cytokines that actually can break down the skin, but at the same time, they can also break down the glands. And then another use for intense pulse light is for patients with acne and for facial rejuvenation. And we know that the applying intense pulse light to the skin will actually decrease the amount of inflammatory mediators and inflammatory cytokines on the skin. So one study showed that patients with acne have an increase in interleukin-9 on the skin. You apply intense pulse light and you can decrease the amount of interleukin-9. And then this process of photomodulation, the use of light to stimulate the mitochondria of cells so that the cells work better. Another mechanism of action that's going to be talked about more and more here in the future is heat shock proteins. So in 1960, two researchers were looking at the chromosomes of flies. They went out for lunch. The air conditioning in their laboratory broke down. It created a lot of heat. They thought their experiments would be done. They went back, looked at them under a microscope, and found that those chromosomes had not been destroyed, but actually thickened. And when they looked at why these chromosomes had thickened, they found these heat shock proteins. The one that is being talked about the most right now is heat shock protein 70. What do heat shock proteins do? They actually are the chaperones of translocation. So they help DNA work better. And if you apply intense pulse light to cells, you actually will increase heat shock proteins, and when you increase the heat shock proteins, the DNA will work better. So not only is this helping at the cellular level, but when you're applying intense pulse light, you're going to get improvement at the chromosome level. The IPL system that I'm using now is the Luminous M22. The advantages of this IPL as opposed to other xenon flash lamps is that you have a chilling plate here. So one of the downsides of older IPL systems is that heat that's being generated actually starts breaking down the epidermis of the skin. So after you apply an IPL treatment with an older IPL system, you're going to have to wait about 6 weeks for that skin to regenerate, that epidermis to regenerate before you can give them another treatment. With this little chiller plate on the M22, you can actually treat these patients every 2 weeks because there's not this breakdown of epidermis. The other thing is you have the ability to actually pulse your energy. So darker patients need less energy than lighter patients because the melanin in the skin will absorb these wavelengths of light and fluences that you're applying to the patients. So with the ability to change the pulses on the machine, you can start treating darker and darker skin levels, and this gives you an advantage with the M22. So there's several papers now. We've published 3 or 4 of these papers, and now we have doctors in other centers throughout the United States, Duke and Mayo Clinic, Dr. Dell. A recent paper on IPL looking at its effect on inflammatory cytokines in the tear film was published by ourselves and a group out of China. And it was 44 patients, ages 23 to 86. They got a sham treatment on one side, IPL on another. They got 3 treatments. They got expression after each of the 3 treatments. We looked at interleukin-17, interleukin-6, and PGE2. And what we found after 3 treatments is that we could clinically significantly decrease the amount of interleukin-17 and clinically significant decrease in interleukin-6. There was a decrease in PGE2, but it wasn't clinically significant. Other light treatments that I've been working on, and this is another thing I've been working on for the last 10 years, is are there more specific wavelengths of light that can be used by patients at home to help their meibomian gland dysfunction? So we were talking about before, adding something to your treatment so that these patients maintain their good secretions and their good meibomian gland function. So we started looking at wavelengths anywhere from 400 nanometers all the way to infrared. And this is one study that we presented at ARVO last year looking at red light treatment in our office, and so that these patients would come in, they'd get a red light treatment, and we looked at their meibomian gland function. So we looked at tear breakup time, and we also looked at patient satisfaction. So much like IPL, we got an increase in tear breakup time, not as significant as what we were seeing with intense pulse light, but it was significant enough that we said this could be a treatment for patients to take at home. So these wavelengths and these powers that we're using are about 3 joules, as opposed to intense pulse light we're using anywhere from 10 to 16 joules. So now we have a home light device that we have the patient take home, and they apply this home light device for maintenance treatment. And what it's done, it's extended the life of the IPL so that they don't have to come in every 6 months or every 9 months for an IPL treatment. They can extend that out to getting IPL treatments once a year. All this information is in my book. Again, I will talk about my book, Dry Disease Treatment in the Year 2020. And that's basically it.
Thank you.